Jonas from Slockit. So I'm going to talk about the Opinionator. So what is it? Basically, it's a tool which we developed because we thought, well, if you want to do governance which is connected to blockchains, you cannot just use coins as a measurement of who's able to vote for what, because obviously we don't support just rich people. So what we did, we took a look at what can the blockchain else offer for us and what other measurements we can take. And we found four main categories. Obviously coin holdings, which is already used for carbon vote, for example. The other one, which is pretty straightforward, is consumed gas. So basically how much gas did you use on the blockchain? So it's kind of like a proof of burn, right? So how much did you actually spend? The other one is probably the most interesting one, is that we also count how much gas was spent on your smart contract. So let's say, for example, you invent a crazy contract which produces some cats, for example. Yeah? Let's call it CryptoKitty, for example. So if there's going to be a change in the blockchain, like a protocol change, you want to give this person a vote as well, because he has a lot to lose. Let's say he has millions of users. If this would be a change that influences his contract, he wants to have something to say as well. So maybe he doesn't have enough money because it's open source or whatever. And this is a way we can help him to open, like to voice his concerns, for example. And the last one, obviously, which is often overlooked, is mine difficulty. Because the miners obviously are the ones who are actually running the whole thing. So we included this as well. So I kind of already talked about this, what can it be used for. What we did not do is we didn't make a voting tool, because it's kind of a totally different question on how to count votes, who's allowed to vote. So what we did, it's more like a signaling tool. So let's think about the current governance system for Ethereum, for example. How it works is that there are a bunch of smart people sitting in a room talking about the future. And then they kind of like look at Twitter and see what's going up with the community. It's the only way they can do it currently, but there's obviously a better way. And the Opinionators for one example for this. So what they can do, they can create a poll saying, okay, there's ERP-183, for example. No, go and vote. So everyone who has anything to do with the chain can vote. And now they actually can make the decisions upon the base foundation of what the community thinks about this. And especially what parts of the community think about this, right? So they can say, okay, what do the developer think about this? What are the power users think? What are the miners think? What are the investors think about the current solution? And then they can take this, individualize the results that they like, and then make more a better judgment about what to do and how to go forward. How to implement it? It's a pretty straightforward architecture, database, backend, UI, blockchain. So what we did is we put the polls on the blockchain, but the votes are actually off-chain because we don't want the users to pay for voting. So we developed a scheme how to make sure that we don't cheat. So first of all, polls on the blockchain, so we cannot change that. Once it's there, it's there. And then the votes are basically just signed messages containing the address of the poll, because it's a smart contract, and his decision on what did you vote. And this is signed, and then he sends it to us, we sign it back and send it back to him. This way we can ensure that no one cheated. Here's an example how it looks like. So vote contains a message, a version, and a signature, and the message contains actually the contract address, the poll ID, and the proposal ID. So I always know what is actually signed, and this looks like this is just a string JSON object, and for each vote you get the receipt. So and why is it needed? Basically it's because of trust. So we have an open API which shows all available votes, and you want to check now, did they count my vote? So all you have to do in quotes, all counts gas, or let someone else count the gas, because like you saw in the architecture, what I didn't explain, we have a huge database which basically collects all data from the blockchain. So the whole state is passed into a database, so we can easily account all the votes, because if we count how much gas was spent on the contract, we have to do a huge query, and this will spit out some numbers. It's not very feasible for a user. I mean, currently, because you need a full archive node for this, which takes a lot of space, I think like 250 gigabytes, and a lot of computational power, and you have to run it all the time. So it's more like a thing you want to outsource to third parties. But basically, it's all open information, right? That's the whole point of the scheme. it's open information, everyone can get it, everyone can count it. And what you then do, you take all the votes from our API and just check the numbers. If your vote is not there in the API, you know we already cheated because it's not there. If the numbers are wrong, you also know there's something wrong. Other side is obviously we don't want to be scammed as well. So let's say someone claims he has voted and shows the numbers. We cannot say, okay, well, show us the receipt because we signed your vote, you should have it. And if you don't have it, you didn't vote. So this way, we ensure both sides are not getting scammed by the other one. Obviously, it's still centralized, but it's still trusted. Showtime, let me show what we did. Very basic UI. It's not pretty fancy. I'm not a UI guy. So what you have here are basically all the polls currently. This is on the Ethereum mainnet. So let's take, for example, this one, right? This is Progressive Proof of Work EIP. This is now fetching the data from the blockchain. That's why it's taking so long, because we have to request the data from MetaMask. MetaMask asks the... And here you can see the title, a description. Basically, the description usually just sends you through a link, because the more data you put in the poll, the more expensive it is to create the poll. You see how did the poll, who did the poll, and then you have dates, right? When did it start, when did it end, and how many people voted. So now it's the interesting part is here, right? So let's say, for example, the yes vote, when we pop this open, we see a bunch of numbers. So basically, this is the mining vote, total difficulty mined. This is sum of all votes. So no one would mind the block have voted on this, which is not surprising. Right over here, we have the developer vote. This is all gas summed up by the votes who voted yes, spent on their contracts, right? Then you have coins, so Ether, and gas spent, which is the biggest number. And the same with for no, right? Same thing. And then down here, you see, it's currently pretty even. We have 51 to 48. But if you know, for example, say, okay, this is would be, for example, the appeal that influences investors more. You can just pull the slide and see how it changes, right? So if you know, take, okay, gas doesn't really matter for me much, right? You take this down a bit, or developer doesn't count. You see how the votes shift. And this way, you can basically say, I have a very specific problem for a very specific user group, and I can adapt my polls for this. So I always know who in the community thinks what and how should I react now. And this is basically the gist of it. It's connected to MetaMask, it's also working without MetaMask. Then you simply cannot create a poll because you need the key and stuff. Voting works with and without. With MetaMask, it's easier, just press a button. I can show this, for example, if you go here, right? Say I want to vote yes. Basically, you just press send with MetaMask, and then you will receive a pop up, which is on this screen. It just asks you to send this transaction, right? So it just signs the message. This message will be sent to Slockit. Slockit signs it back, sends you the receipt. Pretty straightforward. If you don't use MetaMask, you will just have to sign the string manually however you want it. You can use it with a command line, you can use it with my Ether wallet or whatever. Yes. Cancel this. And creating. Also very straightforward, just put the name of the poll, the description, start and end date, and standard this poll, basically, if you want to have a yes or no question, then click this, it's a little bit cheaper than do the proposals yourself. If you don't click this, you can create it yourself. For example, let's say you have a question, what's your favorite color? Then you can create different colors, so let's say blue, green, blue, whatever. They can vote on this, and also they can propose another proposal and say, okay, my color isn't there, my friend's color is let's say black, and he can then propose it to the poll owner and he can accept it or not. This is also possible. And this way, it's currently standalone. We are working with some other teams who are currently working on improving the ERP process, using the signaling tool to improve Ethereum governance, make it a little bit more transparent and more straightforward for the developers. Yeah, there's a GitHub We don't have a good documentation on this, to be honest. The API is also open source. Just check the code for the backend. It's, if you know anything about coding, it's very easy. You just see all the endpoints there. Yeah, smart contract also, and I already spoiled the next one. Check it out. If you have any questions, just message me, Jonas at Slockit. That is, thank you very much.